Good day, everyone. This is Sir AJ Aliado, and I'm a senior high school teacher. And for our today's lesson for Earth and Life Science, we will be talking about the uniqueness of the Earth. So our learning objective for today is to recognize the uniqueness of Earth being the only planet in the solar system with properties necessary to support life. So why is the Earth unique? The Earth is unique because it is the only planet known that supports life, with all the expeditions outside the Earth, to the Mars, to other planets in the solar system, and even outside the solar system, it is the only planet known that has life on it. So what are the Earth's unique features that makes it habitable or makes the existence of life possible? I have summarized the unique features. We have the right distance from the sun, the type of planet, the size, and the atmosphere. So one by one, we will be discussing this unique features briefly. So first unique feature is the distance from the sun. Located in the Milky Way, the Earth is making its revolution around the sun in our solar system. It is the third planet away from the sun. The Mercury, the Venus, and then the Earth, making it 93 million miles away in average for the distance away from the sun. It is located in the Goldilocks zone, or the habitable zone, where it is in the optimal distance away from the sun. The only known planets, or the only planets that are located in this zone, is Earth and Mars. It is located in the habitable zone where it is not too close from the sun to be too hot and not too far away to be too cold. So it is very comfortable, or we are situated in a very comfortable location. The next one is a type of planet. We have two types of planet, the terrestrial and Jovian planets. When we say terrestrial planets, these are the rocky planets now. The first four planets in our solar system, which is Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Another type of planet is the Jovian planets, or the gaseous planets composed of liquids and mostly gases. And these are now the Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Remember that Earth is a rocky planet or a terrestrial planet, which is of course composed of rocks. And these rocks now carry minerals to support life. And the next unique feature is its size. Okay, remember that size is equal to gravity. Depending now on the size, it carries now a certain amount of gravity. Remember that bigger size of planet have a stronger gravity and smaller size planets have a weaker gravity. Comparing now to the Earth and the Mars, the Earth is almost twice as large as the Mars, so it has a stronger gravity. A stronger gravity or strong gravity now entails a much more stable atmosphere, okay? And a much more stable atmosphere, meaning it can hold now the necessary gases. We will be talking about more of this atmosphere later for the next slide. Remember also that comes with the size, comes now the size of the core. The Earth's core provides now the magnetic field that protects us from the solar flares and asteroids that might hit us. Okay, it deflects now the solar flares coming from the sun, of course, and some asteroids that might hit us on its way. Okay, and the next unique feature is the atmosphere. The atmosphere now contains necessary gaseous elements for survival. Mostly it is composed of nitrogen, necessary for plant life, and of course plants are very important for the survival of humans and other animals at 78%. It also contains now oxygen, the 21% that is necessary for animal survival, We have argon at 0.93%, carbon dioxide at 0.03%, and water vapor at 0 to 4%, and some trace gases rather for less than 1%. The atmosphere also protects us from asteroids and comets, and it protects us from UV rays. The ultraviolet rays causes harm to humans and other animals. The atmosphere also sustains the liquid water. And remember, where there is liquid water, there is life. The atmosphere also maintains enough warmth suitable for life. Now again, not too cold and not too warm. Okay? But as of today, we are experiencing some rage of wars and breeze of cold, too cold, because of the destruction or the holes in our atmosphere. That is why it's very important for us to take care of the atmosphere, okay? Or rather the ozone layer, which is situated now in the atmosphere. And let us now summarize our lesson. So again, the Earth is at the right distance because it is located now in the Goldilocks zone. The Earth is also a terrestrial planet which supports life, and it is the correct type of planet, and it is also in the correct size, and it carries now the right atmosphere equals life. So remember, guys, to protect our life support system or the Earth, okay? Because it provides now the necessary things to support us, not only humans, not only animals, but also plants and other all living organisms. Okay, so to end this lecture, let's talk about the quote from Huangzi. We have, life comes from the earth and the life returns to earth. Remember that since the earth is providing us with our life, we should give in return to take care of our mother earth. Again, this is Sir AJ Aliado, and that I will be seeing you for our next lesson. Have a great day and take care. Goodbye.